गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास। आई नो यू ऑल आर टेकिंग प्रॉपर केयर ऑफ योर हेल्थ एंड हेल्पिंग योर पेरेंट्स इन वन अदर अदर वे एट होम। स्टूडेंट्स, ऑलरेडी पोएम वन, पोएम टू एंड फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच आर कंप्लीटेड। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू पोएम थ्री, ए टाइगर इन द जू बाय लेस्ली नरिस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर अप द कंटेंट अबाउट द पोएट, अबाउट द पोएम, न्यू वर्ड्स, मूड ऑफ द पोएट एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन। Literary devices used in the poem, rhyme scheme and message conveyed are your assignment. You try to do yourself and later on in the next class we'll discuss about this. About the poet, Leslie Norris was a famous Welsh poet and short story writer. He had decided even at an early age that he would become a poet. Although he earned his living as a college lecturer, teacher and headmaster up to 1974. Later his works won various awards. This poem, A Tiger in the Zoo, is a beautiful poem which brings a contrast picture of a tiger when it is in its natural habitat and when it is imprisoned in a zoo. The poet has revealed the pathetic condition of a tiger when it is imprisoned in a cage in the zoo. Through this poem, the poet has strongly raised a concern over the imprisonment of animals by human beings and advocated granting freedom to animals too, because freedom is the birthright of everyone. Mood of the poet is full of pity because the poet felt very pity for this caged animal, caged tiger. Along with the explanation, I will give you the meaning of the new words used in the poem. Let's move for the explanation of the poem. First stanza, he stalks in his vivid stripes the few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. See student, here he is used for the tiger. So here actually for animals we use it, but here the poet has used he. That means it's clearly seen that the poet has personified the tiger here. It is personification because a human pronoun it is given here. He stalks, stalks. What is the meaning of stalks? Stalks means walks in an angry or proud way. In his vivid stripes, vivid means bright. Stripes means long narrow lines of orange and black color that cover the body of the tiger. The few steps of his cage in which the tiger is imprisoned. On pads of velvet quiet, pads means soft part on the bottom of the paws of the tiger. Velvet, it is a fabric, a soft silk cloth. Quiet means calm, silent, noiseless. Rage means extreme anger. So you must have well understood the new words used in this stanza and their meanings. Let me explain it. He stalks in his vivid stripes the few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. In the very beginning stanza, the poet portrayed the mental condition of a caged tiger. Here he refers to the tiger in the zoo. He is imprisoned in a cage, I told you in the beginning. According to the poet, the tiger moves up and down his cage. The stripes on his body are of bright color and he walks quietly, silently, only a few steps in his cage. His on pairs of velvet quiet means his pairs are soft like velvet, which make his movement noiseless or quiet. In his quiet rage, see students, here quiet rage, contradiction is there. What contradiction? Because rage means extreme anger. Anger is generally expressed by noise and disturbance. But here the rage, the anger of the tiger is quiet. It is calm. It is noiseless. It is silent. Why? Why it is silent? Because the tiger is caged. The tiger is imprisoned in a cage, so he cannot express his anger, rather he has to suppress his anger. Now the question arises, why is the tiger angry? He is angry, of course, because he is confined to a small cage. He is deprived of his freedom. It is not the true quality of the tiger. A tiger being a ferocious animal, a tiger shows its anger. A tiger expresses its rage by creating great noise by its violent nature. But here the tiger is imprisoned in a cage. It is not his true quality. It is not his true personality. Because he is confined to a small cage and deprived of his freedom, he is angry. But he is not able to express his anger, so his anger is quiet. This quiet rage, it shows how the surrounding atmosphere affects one's mood. In the quietness of his cage, even the rage of the tiger is quiet and suppressed. So hopefully students, you understood the first stanza. Now let's move to the second stanza. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the waterhole where plump deer pass. What is the meaning of lurking? Lurking means waiting quietly and secretly before attacking its prey. Sliding means moving quietly, sliding. Near the waterhole means water bodies, ponds, where plump means fat, healthy, deer pass. In the first stanza, the poet portrayed the mental condition of a caged tiger, I told you. In the second stanza, the poet presents the picture of a tiger in its natural habitat. Actually, students, when the poet looked at the imprisoned tiger, the poet is filled with pity. So that what is the thinking of the poet? The poet says that the poor tiger should have been in its natural habitat instead of being caged in the zoo. He says the poor tiger should have been in his natural habitat, that is jungle. Then what he would have done, the tiger? Then he would have been hiding in the shadow. He would have been hiding in the waiting quietly and secretly in the shadow of the trees and sliding quietly through long grass. Why? For what? To ambush his prey. There near the water hole, he would have been waiting for some fat deer, some healthy deer to pass that way to drink water. So this way the poet says that actually the true personality of the tiger is hunting and resting in the shadow of the trees, not getting imprisonment in a cage. Let's move to the next stanza. He should be snarling around houses. What is the meaning of snarling? Snarling means making an angry sound. At the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, baring means uncovering, exposing, showing. His white fangs means long sharp teeth. His claws and terrorizing the village, terrorizing means frightening the village. Here in this third stanza, the poet expresses the desire of a caged tiger. The poet says that had the tiger not been in his cage, what he would have done? The poet says that had the tiger not been in his cage, he would have been roaming around freely. He would have been snarling around the houses at the edge of the jungle. He would be frightening the villagers. How? By baring his white fangs and his claws. So this way the tiger would have expressed himself had he not been caged in the zoo, had he not been imprisoned in a cage in the zoo. Students, in this stanza, the poet is giving a hint, the poet is giving a warning to the human beings that if we destroy the natural habitat of the tigers, if we destroy the forest the way we are doing, they will be forced to turn to our villages and towns to find their food. It is true that human beings, they are snatching the natural habitat of these animals by destroying the forest, by cutting the forest and expanding their own areas. As a result, it's a great threat to the human beings that these wild animals will start coming to the towns and villages to find their food. Let's move to the next stanza. But he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stalking the length of his case, ignoring visitors. But he is locked, everywhere he is referred to the tiger. But he is locked in a concrete cell. Concrete means solid. Strength means his power. Stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Ignoring means he is paying no attention, no notice to the visitors. Visitors, those who come to visit the zoo, public. So, in this fourth stanza, the poet reveals the pathetic condition of a caged tiger. The poet means to say that the tiger should be free in its natural habitat and show, the tiger should show its true personality. But unfortunately, the mighty tiger, the powerful tiger is locked behind the bars in a concrete cell in the zoo. His unbound strength, his strength behind bars, his unbound strength is behind the bars of the cage. He is not able to do anything. He moves up and down the cage, ignoring the visitors. Because he does not care for the visitors, he is indifferent to them, as he is not getting any sort of help from the visitors. He knows that he will not get any help from these people. So, ignoring the visitors, he is moving up and down the cage. His strength, his unbound strength is also behind the bars. So, in this way, in stanza 4, the poet has revealed the pathetic condition of a caged tiger. Now, the last stanza. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars. Patrolling means monitoring or supervising. And stares means gazes, looking at something continuously. In this last stanza, fifth stanza, the poet expresses the pangs of a caged tiger, and the poet shows his empathy for the tiger. The poet is saying that the tiger keeps awake till late in the night. He hears the noise of the patrolling cars. What are patrolling cars? Why do cars patrol at night? The cars, the forest team of the forest officials, they supervise and safeguard the animals in the zoo. So, the tiger keeps awake till late in the night. He hears the noise of the patrolling cars moving around in the zoo. Being locked in the cage, he looks towards the sky and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Because he is locked in the cage, he looks out towards the sky. He stares the brilliant stars that are shining freely in the sky like his brilliant eyes, like his bright eyes. Why do the tigers look at the sky? This is the question. The tiger looks at the sky, it gazes at the sky, it gazes at the brilliant stars. It signifies that the tiger's reminiscences of his full freedom once he had in the vast forest. The freedom that he lacks now but longs for, perhaps he is expecting that he will be free one day. Both brilliant eyes and brilliant stars symbolize brilliance and power. So this way the poet very beautifully depicted a beautiful picture of freedom and captivity, how a tiger in its natural habitat enjoys its freedom, and how a tiger in a cage in the zoo suffers the captivity and remembers his past days about his freedom in the forest. Up to this it is completed, students. Now your assignment is find out the rhyme scheme, literary devices used in the poem, and message conveyed through this poem. Take care of yourself. Rest in the next class. Thank you.